toad in a room. I know you got to have your rest. She says, come lay beside me. I've been waiting since you left. Took my breath away. I might not get to heaven, but I walked with the angels that day. She takes me by the hand. I am the luckiest man.
Get over here. Sister tells her boyfriend, be back in a while. Boyfriend wants a beer, the store is just a mile. He leaves the motor running, he'll only be a minute. His car drives away with teenagers in it. The driver tells his buddies, got one life to live. They scream into the night, let's get it over with.
hits a big boy in the Shoney's parking lot. He flies through the air, takes out the bank clock. Clock strikes a light pole, transformer sparks. Lines go downtown, goes dark. Waitress calls the cops, says she saw it all. Swears a giant alien has landed at the mall. Cops ring up the mayor, says there's panic in the streets. We hate to wake you up, but we can't find the chief. Mayor says use your head if he ain't in his car.
He's hiding from his wife down at Smokey's bar.
Cause and effect, chain of events, all of the chaos makes perfect sense. When you're spinning round, things come undone. Welcome to Earth, where to rock from the sun. Cause and effect, chain of events, all of the chaos makes perfect sense. When you're spinning round, things come undone. Welcome to Earth, where to rock from the sun. Welcome to Earth, where to rock from the sun. Welcome to Earth, third rock from the sun. Welcome to Earth, third rock from the sun.
Good morning, WBAM Radio. Morning, Jen.
Good morning, Bonley Johnson.
How are you?
I am fantabulous for a Monday morning. How are you?
Did you sleep your birthday off yet?
I slept quite a bit. Yeah. I did nothing yesterday.
Good. That's what Sundays are for. Or they should be for that anyway. I mowed a little grass, but it was so dusty that I quit. About three quarters of the way through, I was like, yeah, fuck that noise. I was coughing and hacking. Bleh. Nope. I smoked enough cigarettes Friday night. I didn't need any more.
Oh.
That's the somebody one thing was, about bar life I don't miss.
Somebody was smoking weed after you left.
Was it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Glad I missed out on that.
Yeah, I did not. It was not. Didn't smell that good.
We don't, I don't shit on other people for doing it. It's just not.
No, I don't either.
It's not for me. You know.
I don't either.
You and I have the exact same reaction to it.
Yeah, to each their own, you know, whatever. But God, it stinks.
Yeah. It's, especially them, you know, let's call a fucking spade a spade here. These fucking poor people smoke that skunk weed and shit that grow out fucking behind their house. And it
cigarettes
smells fucking.
Awful. Cigarettes are the same way.
Yeah, cheap cigarettes like smell.
The cheap cigarettes smell so bad.
Yeah, they don't have the right amount of formaldehyde and stuff in them to make, to make them good. That's just the way it is. Good morning, Layla. Who we got in chat this morning besides the beautiful Layla?
We got Jen.
Jen's in. Pudding's in. That's enough.
I haven't seen. Oh, good morning, Pudding.
That's enough.
How are you, ho?
Man, we are loaded with some beauties this morning. What's up with that?
I know. I didn't see her sneak in.
Maybe I shouldn't have rubbed one out so early this morning. I could have saved it for later, but I guess
not. Why you have to make every day freaking gross?
That's my job. That's what WBAM pays me to do. to gross you out. Maybe I don't even want to hear it from you, you old perv.
Maybe we need to pay you more.
I ain't gross enough for you yet, baby.
No.
You want me to turn it up a notch?
No. Why are you calling me an old perv for?
Because you are an old perv. What do you mean? Same reason I tell you you're a great person when you're a great person. I call it what it is. You can't have one without the other.
I am officially old now. I have crossed over that hill.
Yeah, you hit the button.
Yeah.
That's the button.
I've reached the peak.
But happy birthday again. And everybody tell you happy. Her birthday was Saturday, of course, but we celebrated starting Thursday and finished up Saturday. Or she did anyway. With her little boat trip.
Yeah. That was fun. That was fun, by the way. And then at that point, I was actually, when I found out what, because my sister took me out, it was a surprise and I had no idea what I was going to be doing. And of course, the people who are listening still have no idea, but it was a riverboat cruise. She took me on a little, on a riverboat cruise. And the night before, when you were in, they were doing it in my town. This was in a neighboring town.
Oh, okay. But, I just assumed you guys left in the same spot.
No, no. We left from Ashland, Kentucky.
Okay.
And, but anyway, that night before when they were doing it in our town and, you know, I thought that would have been something neat for the two of us to have done. You know, 'cause they serve dinner or you can get dinner tickets and everything. But anyway, so then when I went and did it the next night, I thought, well, I guess I'm kind of glad I didn't do it tonight.
Right. Doubling down. Yeah, it would have lost its panache.
Yeah.
A little bit of its zip. I'm cool. I'm glad you got to go with that. I am good with it.
My sister and I had actually done it before years ago. Yeah. Yeah. But, you know, we were drinking then.
Yeah. You didn't drink Saturday?
No. No, I don't drink anymore at all.
I know, but there's always exceptions to the rule. You did turn 50.
I did. Yeah. But I did pay $4 for a fucking water.
Oh, was it a good one?
No, it was like.
They just reached down in the river. Pulled your glass
off. Yeah. Pretty. Yeah. Oh God. That's so gross. That river's nasty. But it was a bottled water, but it wasn't like anything special. It wasn't a $4 fucking bottle of water. I'll tell you that.
God, there's so much interesting stuff in your area. I was driving.
There is?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, there's a place called PP Creek.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. There used to be a gas station there next to PP Creek. PP Creek. And there was a gas station called PP Gas.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Somewhere there, Channel 10, I think it was Channel 10 News, actually had a blooper reel of a reporter doing a story from PP Gas. and he got tickled, like he could not do it. Took him forever.
Well, I mean, I laughed, drove by. I was like, did I see what the fuck I just saw? I said, look in my mirror on the other lane. Like, sure enough, fucking PP Creek. Like, Jen goes there when she wants to feel good about herself. I love the word PP. It's her favorite word for a penis.
Yeah.
It is.
I know. I love it.
Beep, beep. You and burgers can celebrate.
Give me, I just can't even say it. Yuck, it's just gross. You can't make it sexy. It just can't be done.
Yeah. It's supposed to be funny and cute, but I don't even think it's that really.
It's disgusting.
I think out of habit, you get those words. But
it's something that you use with your 3-year-old child.
Right. I didn't. I'm pretty sure I used penis, but I felt uncomfortable telling Alex penis.
Well, what did you?
I'm pretty sure that's what I used. What was I taught? It. It, yes. My mother was so Catholic. How Catholic was she? Well, I'll tell you. She was so Catholic that she was against even babies touching their wieners. You know, kids, they explore naturally. That's what they do. But she was shit so beat into her by the nuns that it was a sin that she would put vinegar on my fingers to keep me from touching it. Which, you know, explains a lot now. I like the abuse, so it all goes back to those days.
You keep vinegar on hand?
Alcohol now. Yeah,
I like to burn. Moving on up.
Be a man. Use alcohol.
You got to push the envelope.
Yeah, yeah. But those Catholics, I mean, you know, God love them, but man, that guilt shit. I told you stories about that. Like my first wife, like, you know, we had to do it under the covers and all that because of the pictures of the dead relatives.
Grandparents.
The dead relatives are watching you. That's great. put on a show for Grams. Grams is watching. Let's put on a show. But yeah, terrible. So what did you, we had fun Friday night. If everyone listening, I think everybody that is listening does know
that I don't know who
the river.
We don't know who's listening.
That's true. I'm just going by chat, I guess, but that's not true because we have way more listeners than that. They were on early today and often. So I'm glad. Welcome to WBAM if you're new and you're listening. And if you're old and you're listening, well, welcome anyway.
We do appreciate you tuning in.
So after Friday's show, the Morning Bull show, I had my stuff pretty much packed. I ended up forgetting toothpaste, but, you know, whatever. I thought, and the reason I forgot it is because I thought I had it. I went to the dentist. Thursday, I think it was. Had my cleaning.
I don't remember what day it was. No, we were on the floor. It was Wednesday. So it had to be Wednesday.
Yep,
yeah.
It was on Wednesday. And I had the little goodie bag that they give you out in my truck still.
Yeah.
And I left it there on purpose so I would have it, a travel pack to go to your house. And there was no Makes toothpaste sense. In it. They gave me fucking those stupid threaders for my bridge instead of toothpaste. Like, you fuckers. I don't want that. I have a billion of those things. I want a toothpaste. So I never even looked in the bag. It's my own fault.
So maybe.
So I drove home 3.5 hours for stank mouth just to brush my teeth.
Ew.
I know, right?
Gross.
Well, I didn't talk to anybody, so other than the poor guy at the desk. I need to check out.
Hi.
What's your name? Tom. What's yours?
Thomas.
So I didn't tell you.
Most people pronounce it Thomas, but my mom like Thomas.
Thomas. I didn't tell you what happened when we got into the hotel.
No.
When you and I after dinner.
Yeah.
When we stopped in to wait on to listen to Tisha's show.
Right.
I don't know if I should tell you what happened. I'm going to leave that up to you.
I mean, I don't know what it is, so how in the hell can I? Yeah, I don't care.
What happened when we first got there?
I had to go to the bathroom.
Right.
I was going to freaking die.
That's what the story involves.
Oh, I don't care. So. I mean, everybody craps.
So.
I thought I was going to die. You're just taking your sweet time. Oh, I got this trailer park.
So I'm standing there.
Motherfucker, I'm about to.
Yeah, I know. I was trying to get my, because I had lost my key card at dinner for the room. So I was up at the front desk and Jen's like, I got to go. And she just takes off for the bathroom while I'm getting my card.
Gone.
And I got my card and I'll just wait over here by the. There was a big window where you can see down into the pool. So I was just watching people swim, standing there, probably looking creepy. I don't know, whatever.
And let's watch the little kids in their little swimsuits.
It was just a couple old fat people, but whatever. To each their own. They could have been hot. I don't know. But this maid or whatever, hotel employee comes flying around the corner to go into the bathroom, and then another one comes flying out while you were in there. And the girl that was coming out says, do not go in there. She said, there's somebody in there. Do not go in there. The other girl says, I can't wait. So she's prancing around outside trying to, you know, hold it. And then she just rushes in, and then she comes out before you. I thought she was dying. I wasn't sure. I don't know what you did in there, but you must
have. Thought I was dying.
You were killing everybody else, too.
I can't help it.
That poor girl.
Sweet relief. Let me tell you that.
But how the hell did they not know I was standing there waiting on you? How fucking rude was that bitch?
Oh, I don't know, but I don't care anyway. I don't. Because let me tell you, the person that was in there when I went in there.
Yeah. Oh, you know what?
Roy in it too.
She fucking probably was deflecting.
Yes.
Oh, now it makes sense.
She was destroying it.
Now it makes sense. Because she went out of her way to blame you.
Yeah, well, I mean, don't get me wrong. I did my own damage, but she was she was tearing it up when I got in there.
There was not one, but there was two chemical spills.
she was, I walked into like a thundering, it was.
That same train that derailed up there in Ohio, Northern Ohio, came down south and derailed again.
Yes. Let me tell you.
Listen, you guys live right by the Ohio River, for fuck's sake. Smells can't be that uncommon down there. I lived by the river. I know what it smells like.
Yeah.
It's not good. There's times where it's fine, and it was beautiful when I was down there. It really was. That area was really nice around the flood wall and all that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's really pretty.
Portsmouth.
Yeah.
Just around that area, but back where the hotel was, and the downtown area was kind of cute too. All right. I can't, not all of it was shitty, but there was a lot of shitty, man.
Like right, like on the way to the bar, kind of downtown.
Yeah.
Well, it's Chillicothe Street, but you don't know that.
No, I don't know that.
So, yeah, they're actually trying to revamp.
Gentrify.
Yeah.
That's the word.
Yeah.
Where honkies move in and try to revamp everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what they're doing in Yorksville, which I told you is the same town.
The same, yeah.
Yeah, it is. It literally is the same town, just different size. Yeah, sorry. Clean the pipes a bit. Sorry. But yeah, I was like, oh no, this is one of those. Oh no. And I'm driving to the hotel, and I get there. I got my trailer on, because if you don't know, I took, when Jen and Tisha and their husbands came to stay, we had bedrooms set up for them. And the bed that Jen stayed in, we don't need anymore. We moved, we were doing a baby's room, so we moved that bed from the baby's room over to Jen's room. And Jen's bed became obsolete, so I offered it to her, and she took it. So I took my trailer and trailered it down there could have it. I'm glad you like it.
You don't like it?
No, I slept in it once just to try it out.
Yeah.
When Barkley was gone. I don't know. It was weird. It was weird. I haven't slept in a regular bed in forever. We use those mattress-only beds where there's no box spring and all that.
Oh, yeah.
I hated it at first, but I've gotten used to it. It's still not comfortable, but...
It shouldn't feel any different.
It does. And it's because it's higher.
So you don't like the higher bed?
Well, I did. And now I'm not used to it anymore. You know what I mean?
You didn't see my upstairs. The bed that I have upstairs is really high. Like you have to have a step to get into it.
Yeah. So. Those are made for love, Megan.
I don't know if they are.
The problem with our bed is her brother built it, made it for her for Christmas one year.
Yeah.
Kind of a weird Christmas gift, but whatever. You know.
Oh, I think it's cool.
And he took the design from Crate and Barrel.
Yeah.
And built it. And it's got this wooden frame around the outside of the bed. Like 10 inches off the ground. Maybe 12. But... around 10, just high enough to hit me in the shin when I'm trying to walk around the bed or when I'm trying to position myself on the edge of the bed to have some fun. It hits me right in the shin. I've got scar tissue on my fucking shins from this stupid thing. I fucking hate it. I told her, I said, you know, if her brother didn't give that as a gift, I would have burnt that motherfucker when we moved. It would never have made the trip. But she didn't want to hurt his feelings, so we kept it.
I think it sounds like you're just being a big whiny-ass crybaby.
The fucking thing hits me in the shin, man. I'm even just walking around, not even when we're fucking, just walking.
Pay attention to where you're fucking going.
You can't get close enough to the bed. My dick ain't that big, I'm sorry. And I ain't throwing no lassos over here.
You said when you were just walking, not when
you were... Yeah, both. I have no depth perception, so I can't see. I can't tell how far away I am from shit.
I ain't going to tell you how to do your thing. Your business is your business. But walking... That's your own fault.
No, it ain't. How many beds have a fucking 8-inch protrusion at the bottom? Usually you can rub right against the mattress and it feels good and you just cruise into the outside of the bed and lay down. Not that one. You got to jump.
You got to watch where you're fucking going.
You do. But you have to sit down from another eight inches away. So if you miss a little bit, you're fucked. On the ground you go. It's not cool. It's not okay. It is not okay.
Whiny ass cry, baby.
What I need to do is have somebody knit me like a doily that goes all the way around it, so it's cushioned.
A padded.
Yes. Just like an old padded toilet seat, but giant.
You need a bumper pad for your bed.
Remember how they had them on the water beds? They were cool then. Why can't they be cool again?
Yeah, I know. I would like to have a water bed.
Do you remember the evolution of the waterbed?
No.
They started out.
How old do you think
out?
I am?
Right around 50, I'd say. Well, they started out. They were
lucky guess.
They started out. All of them were full wave. They're just a water. Water in a fucking balloon. Ooh. In a bed.
Right.
You got in them.
And it was
froze
fun.
Your ass off. Yeah, I mean, they were fun. I you're not wrong. They were fun. But they were cold.
Oh, yeah.
And they were wavy. And, you know, when your partner rolls over. If you're
getting out of the fucking bed.
If he's into thicker girls like I am. They roll you right the fuck out the bed. Send that wave over. Poosh, out you go.
Whoosh, whoosh.
So, yeah. Anyhow. The first stage of evolution was the heater. They started heating them. So you could control the temperature of the bed so it wasn't quite so fucking freezing when you got in them. And they were thermostatically controlled. So when your body temperature heated the water up, it would shut off.
Right.
But they still had problems with those, caused fires, all kinds of issues.
Imagine that. So electricity and water.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who knew?
Yeah, who knew? But it was the part of the bed. It wasn't actually, yeah, but still, you're right.
Oh, I need to interject real quick.
Go ahead.
And then we can go back to it. Are we giving away money today? Because we don't have the tag all, so people are going to have to start picking up.
Yes, money. So 1 through 50. If you want to be in on the win Bonley's money today, that the tag all doesn't work anymore. So 1 through 50, because we're up to $60 now. I'm a little tight. I ain't giving no 25. 1 through 50. Those are your numbers to choose from. First come, first serve. You pick the number. And if you're listening outside of WBAM radio chat, you can text me. Because the odds are that you know me. If you don't know me, then you got to get in WBAM chat. Or you can text Jen if you're somebody else. Kevin and Pat are free to text Puddin. Anybody who you know who would be in WBAM radio chat, you can text them with your number and they can put it all down.
Relay it.
Relay. So anyhow, so the next evolution was padding inside the water for wave reduction.
Baffles.
Yeah, they were kind of like baffles.
Well, that's what they were called, right?
I don't know. Maybe. Maybe
Why
they called
it sound
baffles?
Like there's somebody here. You're...
Well, hopefully it's one of your kids again, surprising you for your birthday.
Well, they're late. Lexi's actually having surgery this morning, so I know it's not her.
Mm. Was she having surgery?
Anyway, she's having a hysterectomy this morning.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah.
And you're not there?
She didn't want me to be.
Oh. Ouch. Sorry. Slapped the shit out of that girl. Do you have my permission?
I don't know. There's just stuff.
It's okay. You're allowed to have stuff. So anyhow,
we got stuff.
I know. Listen, I know. And I speak to my kid like once a month because of our stuff. So he still hasn't recovered from our stuff, which of course, and from my point of view, is his stuff. But whatever, that's a different. Different conversation for a different show.
Okay, baffles.
Yes. So they started adding different types of baffles to them. Because that's a good word. I like that. I'm baffled by any other word. So they would have full wave, so
funny,
semi-wave, and waveless, which was
a bed.
Just a bed. Yeah. So like, what the fuck's the point? And they were all fucking heavy, man. You had to have a heavy duty. You couldn't put those bitches in a mobile home. People did it all the time. But it was not recommended. They told you do not do that because they fucking go right through the floor.
You put it on one end and the other end of the trailer, zoom, jacked up to the moon.
What do you, Bailey, if you're listening, you have to retext me because I have no idea what the fuck you're talking about. Oh, I got you. Now I got you. All right. The other text hadn't come through yet. So anyhow, yeah. You could, not only would you get shot through the moon, but I mean, it would, yeah, you would just fall through the floor and fucking, that would be the end of your trailer. But people did it, including us. my mom and stepdad had a waterbed in our trailer, which was dangerous. Dangerous.
Dangerous.
But I am shocked. I am shocked that they have not made a comeback yet. I think about it all the time. I think about opening a waterbed store because I thought, man, get ahead of the curve.
They were cool. They were not comfortable. They were not. They were just cool.
They were cool to fuck on. That was it. That was the whole appeal to.
And well, the thing is, they really weren't that great for that either.
Oh yeah, if you get the timing right, you got to time the waves as they come in.
Does it decrease your work or I mean, is that how that happens?
I would love to tell you that I fucked on millions of water beds, but it never really happened. So I really don't know. I am seriously just spaghetti-latin right now.
I did one time.
Yeah?
Yeah, one time. Yeah.
He didn't time the waves.
Apparently not.
So I'm guessing it wasn't that great.
It was not that great for me. But I mean, I was young.
Yeah. So. No one knows how to fuck when you're young.
What,
I don't care who
what
you are.
Did I know?
Yeah, you don't know. He didn't know. Nobody knows. It takes time to develop the art of lovemaking. Yeah, right.
Well, funny story with that, though.
Yeah.
It was a party. It was my best friend's 18th birthday party, I think. And her parents were always out of town on her birthday, always, because they went to the Daytona 500 and her birthday is in February. They were always out of town on her birthday. So we decided we were going to have a party. We had said party and my boyfriend lost his watch. We didn't know where the watch was. Her parents found the watch and said, waterbed.
Whoops. I've got a funny story too.
Yeah.
A watch story.
Yeah.
Yeah. When I first started dating Alex's mom, we were drinkers. So we would go out to these, you know how it is. You're a country girl. You've been, you know, you're from the same basic area I'm from. You go out to these like wellheads.
You know how it is. You're a drinker.
You go out to like the wellheads and certain little roads, side roads, places you can park. Mm-hmm. You know, that's where you drink and party. And that's where everybody drinks mm-hmm. and parties. And her and I were out there. We'd go freak with these places and we'd freak with the same ones. And one night she lost her watch. And then she was really, it was like one of her prized possession watches. She was very materialistic. So it was like important to her. And 10 years later, we were out there. We went out there to fuck, but we were drinking too. We'd been married like 10 years at this point. And she goes off to pee in the woods and she pees in the exact same spot and finds her watch. 10 years later, covered in rust.
That's crazy.
That's how much creatures of habit we are. Oh. She went to the exact same spot.
Yeah.
10 years later and peed in the same spot. Found her fucking watch. I couldn't believe it either. She come back, I was like, shut the fuck up. There it was. Bigger than shit, man.
Bigger than shit.
Bigger than shit.
There it was, bigger than shit.
Bigger than shit. It was crazy. Crazy times. But yeah, it was worthless at that point because it was all corroded and nasty. But
still.
Yeah, it's a good story. Good
story. Wish I could find my class ring.
You lost one?
Well, I didn't. I know. I think someone stole it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Is what I think happened.
You'll never find it.
No. But I wish by some chance it would pop up somewhere and I'd see it on Facebook or something. But I won't. I was spoiled and mine was not. Mine was like 14 karat gold and it was, it's melted down. It's gone.
Oh, yeah. Unfortunately, that's like when you have a really nice dog and it gets out. It ain't coming back. If you live in the wrong area, it's not coming back.
Yep, I had a boxer go missing too. Yeah, so.
That's sad. That makes me sadder than the ring.
Yeah.
Because I would never, I wouldn't keep anyone's ring either. I would put it on Facebook, but I would never, ever keep somebody's dog.
I know.
Not without trying to give it back first.
There are good people and not good people.
I hate to say that they're not good people, but that's not.
They're not.
That's not a good thing, right?
There are people who are not good people. Not everybody is good people. Does everybody have some good qualities? Yeah, I do believe everybody has some good qualities, but there are people who are just not good people.
But I love my dog so much. I would be heartbroken if somebody kept one of them. I would never, ever do that to somebody.
I know. Well, I feel the same way. I would never keep someone's dog.
Now, I can't lie. When I do find a pretty dog and it's nice and sweet and I, you know, put it on Facebook, because it does happen, Bailey picks them up. I don't know how the fuck she does it, but everywhere she goes, she finds lost dogs. One time was the neighbor's dog, but we didn't know it was the neighbor's dog. It just got it. It was running down the road fucking chasing shit. And she didn't want it to get hit, so she picked it up. And we called the cops and the sheriff and everybody, and they put it on the website and the Facebook and all that. It was our fucking neighbors right across the road. We just had no idea. And his name was Tyson. We got to meet him several more times after that.
Aww.
Because he was one of those wandering dogs. He would just take off and go do his thing. But we didn't bother him after that. We're like, just let him go. We don't want him to get hit. But, you know, I mean, you can't stop him.
What do you do?
Yeah. We're not picking him up anymore. We felt bad because we kept those people away from their dog for a day, but and they were probably worried sick because he didn't come home. But they let him run, so kind of,
Well,
you kind of feel sorry, but you kind of don't.
Might have saved his life that day.
That day may have
been the day that he got hit.
We had a pen we could quarantine him in and stuff when we were, and she'd bring him home. But in almost every one of them, I was like, man, I really like this dog. I hope no one claims it because I'm fucking terrible. I would have 100 of them. If she wasn't here to baffle me, stop me, keep me from being a fucking psychopath, I would have 100 dogs. It would just be insane. I can't control myself. Same thing with golf carts. That's why I got golf carts like fleas.
I was worried when you were here. I have never seen golf carts in my life the way I saw golf carts when you were here.
She struck the fear of God in me. She's like, that trailer needs to come back empty. And we just spent a bunch of money on a shed and stuff. So we hadn't yet, but we were going to. We did Saturday, by the way, found one.
Oh,
finally.
Did you? Good.
Yeah,
finally. Good.
Well, there was we go to this sushi place. It's not really a sushi place, but they do have sushi. It's a Japanese kind of restaurant. And it's down in Cambridge. And it's not in a very, very nice area. It's down by the Rural King. So it's not where you'd expect to find a good Japanese restaurant. But the food's not bad. It's really not bad. You just never know.
No.
So we go there, and there's these sheds. And I'd been talking to this guy. But he told me that the closest one to me was down by Marietta. For this 5-star structures. And right there it was in Cambridge. I'm like, that's fucking like 15 minutes from my house. Not even 10 minutes from where the property is. I'm like, this guy, either he was lying to me or he had no idea where I was. So anyhow, we just stopped in. And I'm pretty sure I caught the guy watching porn on his phone. He was in the little office shit. And I just walked in, the sign said open, so I didn't knock. he jumped.
Maybe you just startled him.
I don't know, because his hands were still shaking when we were talking about the paperwork.
You mean like shaking?
Shaking. Like, not that. I mean, like trembling.
Okay. Gotcha.
Yeah. Well, it still could have been a startle. You're right.
Maybe.
You know, but I just, you get that feeling. I got that feeling I interrupted something. He may have been on the phone with somebody inappropriate. I don't know. I don't know Mr. Miller's life.
It's so funny.
But I just got that feeling. Anyhow, so I just walk in. I'm like, hey, do you know who this guy is? And he's like, yeah,
Did he jump up with a hard on?
I didn't see. I wasn't looking that closely. He didn't jump up. He stayed in his seat.
I would have totally looked.
But he had his foot up, and he was kind of like leaning back. And then he just kind of propped up real quick. You know, like set up.
I would have totally checked it out.
Like, stand up, you little bastard. I want to see. Let me see.
I'd have leaned over the desk or some shit.
What you got there? What you got your hand there, buddy? What you tossing around over there?
What's you been doing?
I see them two fingers moving. I know you ain't threading no needles. I don't see a sewing machine anywhere. Anyhow, so I'm like, do you know this guy? I was like, he gave me a quote already, but he wanted me to go to this place all the way down here by Marietta. I'm like, it's too far, so I wasn't even going to go. I told her, I was honest. I'm like, I wasn't even going to go check out the buildings because it was just too far. But here you are. And I'm like, is this your guy? And he's like, yeah, that's one of our salesmen. And he's like, what did he quote you at? So I opened up my phone. And I shouldn't let him touch it, but I did. I let him scroll through.
Ew, no, you didn't.
I did. And then I licked the screen afterwards. I was like, man, I taste like ice cream and salt. No, anyhow. So I let him see the quote, and he's like, well, let me run the quote myself. So he did, and it came up to be the exact number. So he's like, well, he's right. This is what it would be for what you want. So I'm like, well, can I buy it? He's like,
okay.
He's like, okay. So we put half down and ordered it. Got the colors we wanted and on our way. Then we went down to the Fireman's Festival in Caldwell. And Barkley, we had a cheeseburger from the fireman's booth. Mm-hmm. Everybody, they are so supportive of the fire department down there. It is ridiculous.
Well, ridiculous. As it should be.
It's good. I mean, it's good.
Yes.
It's ridiculously good. But they have all the food booths set up, but nobody goes to the other ones because everybody wants to support the fire booth. So everyone goes to their thing and orders their food. And like all the restaurants close in the area, so they don't take any of the business away from them. You know,
that's awesome.
It is. It's very tight-knit community. That's why I liked it down there. Still like it down there. That's where we had our first date, and this was what we try to do every year. We missed last year, but we try to every year go down there for our anniversary. It's never on the same day, but same sort of within a week.
Right.
So I get my cheeseburger, decorate it, and she gets her hot dog and decorate it. We went over and ran into my uncle and his wife, so we sat with them. He's the one that just had a stroke here last year. He's still recovering, but he's doing pretty good. He's out getting out and about, and you know, he can understand him when he talks now. So that was pretty cool running into them. We ate. We were going to stay for the parade, but Barkley decided to have some deep fried Oreos, and they didn't sit well. So.
Did she destroy a bathroom of her own?
I don't know. We went to, I mean, she did go to the bathroom, but I didn't ask. I don't ask those questions. Unlike you, she would be horrified if I'm telling this story right now, and she's probably listening. So, so I don't know. I'm going to say no, it was perfect. She went into Pee Pee Creek and pee peed into Pee Pee gas station.
Skittles.
But yeah, so it was a productive Saturday. And then, you know, it was good. It was good.
Good.
I was happy. Everything went well.
Yeah.
So the whole weekend was busy, but fun. Sunday, we didn't do much. We went down to the property and tried to scope out what I got to do to get that shed
already. You already did more than I did.
Yeah.
I got up, made my way from the bed to the couch.
Mm.
I sat there for several hours.
Take it easy.
Then I decided, I believe I'd like to take a nap. So I made my way from the couch to the bed and I took a nap. And I never got out of bed for the rest of the night.
She let me take a nap when I got home Saturday when I drove home from your place.
Yeah.
Yep. I went in and brushed my teeth. And
because you were pretty tired.
I was.
Never have I seen anybody who's not even drinking falling asleep at the bar.
Well, I checked my sugar later. It was way off. So I don't know what I did.
It had been really good all day.
It had been. And then it just blew up, and I don't know why.
So it was high?
High, yeah.
Hmm.
So it makes me kind of lethargic, but not terribly. I was fine. I could have stuck it out.
No.
I was glad you gave me the free out, but
I was not about to make you sit there through that. You were sad and pitiful.
Oh, I was not. I was just quiet and lethargic. Big difference. I was not sad at all. I was enjoying the music.
No, it was sad to me.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't want to drag you down.
You couldn't hang.
Listen, I go to bed at that time. We're up.
I know.
We left at that time after Puddin's show.
Right.
So we went through all of her show and then did the whole karaoke thing down there. And there are some talented singers at that karaoke and some fun singers too.
There are, yeah.
That little boy Connor was fun. He looks like somebody from...
I don't know what he looks like.
Do you know the band Clint Eastwood? That's the ones that sing Clint Eastwood?
No.
What the hell is the name of that band? The Gorillaz?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah. They have a certain kind of art that they use for their videos. It looks like him. Look it up. Okay. You'll be like, fuck yeah, it's him.
It's fucking Connor.
It's fucking Connor. But he was a cool little dude, so whatever.
Yeah, and you know, Trent is just buddies with all of them because they all do karaoke every week, and it's the same regulars, and you know, they're just all big buddies, and you know, that was only my second time going, but
well, they act like they knew you.
Well,
that's good. I mean, when we were at my house for karaoke at that place, it was not like the regulars were not like that. They were kind of, I don't know.
Well, what I love about this place is that everybody's so damn supportive.
Yeah. The other, like I said, when we were up here, they were kind of like haters a little bit. No one shit on anybody, but you could tell that they were just like, eh.
Yeah.
They were just all about themselves.
Everybody at this place is so supportive. It's great.
I wanted to be a dick and announce WBAM radio when I went up, but I was like, yeah.
Well, I have kind of thought about doing that.
Well, I mean, for those people, it might not be like a dick move because they may like want to be a part of this.
Right.
You know, with our karaoke shows.
Some of them are really good people.
They are.
There are a couple who are just, whoa.
Yeah.
Really good. And then there are, even like the people who are like mediocre there are still pretty good.
Yeah, they're still good. They're more fun than they are good. But it was a good crowd.
There's some stinkers, too. I mean, everywhere you go, there's going to be some stinkers.
Right.
But
I only heard one that was off a little bit. And she ended up recovering at the end of her song, and it wasn't that bad. Her pitch was off a little bit for the first half of her song, and the second half of her song, she was on again. So
that
was the only one that was even.
And some of that is nerves.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. I was nervous.
Were you?
Oh, I was riddled. I was ready after the second because I was like, I was that. I would have been ready for the second song had I made it that long, but
yeah,
I would have made it.
Well, I finally got to do a second song.
What did you do?
Not Ready to Make Nice.
Yeah, you told me about that. I still don't know the song, but I know that's what you told me it was called.
Yeah. And by the time that I got up there, everybody was just obliterated drunk.
How many people do you have in chat?
The crowd went wild. I don't know why.
Because I'm getting ready to spin.
Well, it was 1 to 50.
Yeah, but I don't spin 1 through 50, do I? Yeah, I do.
Yeah?
You're right, duh.
Duh.
Fuck it. Forgive me.
Jeez, oh, Pete.
Forgive me. All right. You ready?
Ready.
Boom. Ba-dum, boom. Nice round, even number that nobody picked. I don't see anybody anyway. Anybody pick number 40? 40?
No, I picked 49.
You were the closest one, I think. Let's send it over to Chitty Chat. I got no texts other than from Barkley.
She didn't pick a number?
Nope.
Hmm.
Come on, why is my phone so slow? Trying to send it. There we go. All right, whatever. We're in now. Yeah. So they enjoyed your song?
Well, I mean, they were all...
Just... I know they're drunk, but still, I mean...
Yeah, I mean, I guess.
You get into it.
The crowd went wild.
You get into it. They like drunk. That. The bikers did not like you screaming in their ear, though. I think you're the reason they left.
Good. Good. But they were fucking rude when they left.
Oh, with that. Yeah. Yeah. I think that's why they did it.
Well, I don't care. Rude ass fuckers. They can just take their happy asses right on down to the biker bar and have themselves a rootin' tootin' good
Connor
time.
Connor sang and you're like, wee! Only really loud. And the fucking... yeah, that one. And they fucking all turn around
that's
and look at you.
That's my signature scream.
It's your war cry.
It's something like that. It's the mating call.
The whore cry. And my hoe cry. Puddin', you got one of those? She said she wanted some generic ear pods over the weekend. That was our excitement. Where did you win them at? She said she wants some stuff. And what does she mean by magic fingers bed? Is like one of those hotel vibrating beds?
Well, I don't know.
Is that what she's talking about?
I don't know. Ask her, not me.
Or do they like, you know, magic fingers?
Tell me more.
Is her bed named Rose? That's what I want to know. I don't know these things. This is why we ask.
Tell me. I'm intrigued now about the magic fingers.
Anyhow, we have to wait for her. And there's always a delay.
I know.
It just kills the conversation. Puddin', you need to get faster. You need to get closer to the speaker. So anyhow, yeah, it was a good weekend. We had fun. Everybody there, you know, except for the rude bikers, was pretty cool.
I mean, they weren't that rude. They didn't say anything to me. They fucking knew better.
It was just funny. I was like, I'm going to get beat up again.
They know better. They ain't going to fuck with me. I'll mop the floor with their ass. Because I have like an inner Chuck Norris.
Yeah?
I don't know. Yeah. Like not a lot of people know about that.
People at the jailhouse do.
They do.
I forgot about that. I shouldn't have been worried at all.
You were worried about them?
How about them saying something to you than me having to fucking get in the scuffle? Yeah, I was.
Shit. Shit. I ain't worried about them. Fucking losers.
Mm. There was only one of them that had any kind of size to him. The other skinny dudes, I wasn't going to sweat too bad. I'd give him some Chuck Norris myself.
Watch out. Hi-ya!
I spent So I was such a nerd when I was a kid. I know you're going to shock by that.
When you were a kid?
Yeah. I was not as cool as this collected character that you see now. I was very dorky.
Oh. You mean it gets worse?
It was worse. I was the kid in the library who read those combat magazines. You know, Soldier of Fortune and Karate and Kung Fu magazines.
I'm kind of turned on.
I would just sit there like, hey, I make my own homemade nunchucks. And
out of what? Paper towel rolls?
And... No, mop handles. Mop handles and dog chain. True stories. And then... My uncle, his family had a little bit more money than we did. So he would get, because him and I were inseparable. So we were into the same stuff. And he would always get like throwing stars. We would spend hours, I mean, fucking hours, throwing these stars at the old building and these throwing knives and shit like that, trying to get them to stick, you know. Because they were faux stars. They weren't sharpened. They had points. They could have hurt you, but they weren't like sharpened, razor deadly.
Were you learning the Judy chop?
Oh, we would break boards. Just dumb stuff.
You seriously broke boards?
Mm-hmm. They were rotten boards. But still. They weren't real solid. But it did happen.
Oh, God.
But I had this brother who used to be fucking take shit after me all the time. He'd hit me with baseball bats because he could never whip me in a fight. So he would, whatever weapon of choice he could find, that's what he would beat me with.
Well, you were a scrawny little guy.
I was. And I just remember all that time my uncle and I spent doing that shit. And one day he came after me with this board. I fucking scissor kicked his ass into next week and it struck perfect right on his chin, knocked him out fucking cold.
Oh, shit.
I was like, holy fuck, it worked. I was more surprised than he was.
So then you think you're something special.
And you know what? That was our last fight. He never tried anything ever again.
You knocked his ass out.
Yeah. He never tried it again. Almost once when we were adults, we were drunk. We almost got into it once, but. Yes, we were that family. Woo! Motherfucker.
Well,
I did
not grow up in that family, but I kind of generated that family.
You had the DNA though, right?
No.
No? You said your daddy's family was down that way, so they had to be just like us.
No. I mean they're not though.
No.
Mm-mm.
I just assume a lot, I guess.
The only place I can assume that I got it was from like my mom's mom. She was a little more like me. Like she was just a little more crude, and of course, mom was just mortified. She was embarrassed.
So how did your mom blame your dad when her mom was like that too?
No, mom blamed my dad because of me just being. Honestly, just kind of more country. Like I never.
So it wasn't your crudeness that she.
No. Well, I mean, she hated that too. But
yeah. No. Okay. But, okay. I guess I misunderstood some things.
Yeah. No, it's just that, like mom always, she always just kind of looked down upon country, like just hick, just you know what I mean. Mom didn't like.
Yeah. So I'm starting to catch up now.
And I was never. I mean, I could just never be that uppity, highfalutin type of person that she wanted me to be. I can look the part, but I'm still not that.
So what you're saying is you clean up good?
Yeah. But when I walk in the place, I'm still going to say, howdy.
That's what my in-laws used to say to me, my first set of in-laws. Well, at least he cleans up good.
Yeah.
That was a stray dog.
For a long time, on my voicemail on my phone, my greeting was howdy. And my mom, every time my mom would call me, and she'd say, "My gosh, you've got to change that."
So you're an antagonizer too.
No, I mean, it's just, that's what I like. And I'm not, it took me a long time to be okay with who I was because my mom was not. So,
well, you got to be comfortable in your own skin with who you are. That's where true happiness comes from. You know that.
Right. For a long time, that's what it was. And mom just hated it. She despised it.
But she's got to be happy too. And I understand her too. You know, I would never take her side because she's wrong. But
she wanted me to have a more elite type of life.
Well, because I'll tell you why. You know why. Because, you know.
Because she loved me.
Yes. And when you grow up poor, you want more for your children. You do. And it is because she loved you.
Yeah. I know that.
It's misguided, but still. Mm-hmm. People that, you have to realize where happiness comes from. And once you realize where happiness comes from, then you can be a parent. Because I was the same way with my son. I didn't really push him hard, at least not in my opinion, maybe in his, to do, you know, things a certain way. You know, and mainly it was, I tried to have him avoid my mistakes, but you can't.
No, they are destined to repeat.
Yeah, yeah. You can teach them.
Almost exactly.
Well, I mean, it's your DNA.
Yeah.
I've told you the story about when I first met my dad, when we walked the same, talked the same, laughed the same. And I never met him until I was almost 30 years old. So right. DNA is fucking real. It's real.
Very, very.
So.
I was not as old as you, but when I first met my dad and his family, I understood where I came from.
Yep. And some of it's like a slap in the face.
Yeah.
To me, I was like, oh shit, that's what that looks like. Maybe I ought to back off a little bit.
Well, see, now mine was, I was okay. I was really okay with that. Mm-hmm. I mean, once I got past the anger of not knowing my dad or anything like that, once I got past that anger and I learned him and I learned his family, I was like, I'm fucking badass. These people are cool.
I love my dad's family. He was not a good person. He was not a good person. So I wasn't that fond of him. But everybody else in the family was awesome. Still is. So, you know, a lot of good came from it.
Yeah.
So I don't regret it. The whole meeting thing. I needed all that to happen, just like you did. You got to know where you came from, man. You can't get where you're going if you don't know where you've been. Yep. It's from that song we're singing right now. I can't remember people's names. It's that chunky blonde girl, Miranda Lambert.
Oh,
her and some other guy.
She wasn't always
Luke
chunky.
Bryan or Luke something.
Luke Combs.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know these people. I don't know their fucking names.
He's a chunky bearded guy.
Is he? Okay. I've never seen him. I just heard the song. I like the song, so we're doing a duet. Yeah. I've never seen him. I have no idea what he looks like. I'm staring at Joe Diffie right now. Joe had great hair back in the 90s.
Luke Combs he's a cool fucker.
Is he? Well, maybe I'll listen to more of his stuff. I really like that song.
Oh, he's so good. He's so good. Yes, listen to more of his stuff.
In love is bar. That song, Cameron. But one of the lines in that song is, you can't get where you're going if you don't know where you've been. You can't leave where you've been. Something like that. It's good. It's a good line. And it's the truth.
You'll never find happiness where you lost it.
Nope. Oh boy, ain't that the fucking truth. Hey, I'll give you another one. You can't find happiness in other people. Yeah. You're welcome. But other people can bring you misery.
Ain't that the truth?
They can create the anti-happiness, but they can never create happiness. Just the way it is. All right. Let's get her done. Okay, there we go. Sorry, I had to figure out where the fuck my buttons were. I lost them all. Sorry we didn't give any money away today. That kind of sucked, but we'll try again Wednesday.
We will.
At 9 a.m. with Morning Burr. With me and the beautiful and talented Gen X. So we will see That's you guys me. Wednesday, and we'll try and do this again. 9 a.m. Be there or be square.
Or be square.
That's right. Peace and love, WBAM. Peace and love.
Mucho love.